Hi, this is Team the Dark Side from IIT Jodhpur.
Our project Disaster Chain brings an umbrella of services for disaster detection and early warning systems, along with precautionary steps, while also providing disaster relief services in the aftermath of a disaster. We plan to bring disaster detection to the edge, offloading crucial immediate steps required after a disaster from the cloud, while staying connected to the cloud. Our project is split in two parts. This is the IoT part of the project. It aims to bring disaster detection and early warning systems to the edge from the cloud while staying connected to the cloud. This consists of a distributed IoT-based solution for earthquake detection and early warning systems. Using a Raspberry Pi as a central IoT hub for multiple IoT solutions and smaller Node MCU units acting as slave boards deployed in different rooms or sections of a given building that provide real-time data to the central IoT hub, that is the Raspberry Pi, through API calls. So these units are capable of handling other automation and security protocols that might be useful for any organization, disaster detection being a part of it to provide an early warning system. The central hub, that is the Raspberry Pi, is further connected to Azure through REST API calls that provides a dashboard for monitoring the data collected by the hub. The central hub is mainly responsible for following the safety protocols such as killing the power and water supply, also the gas supply. So power and water, electricity and water, that are major cause of hazards during earthquakes. And gas supply is very obvious, causing fires. And it also provides a sound-based warning system so that everyone can be alerted immediately.
Starting with the smaller battery-powered Node MCU units, these control the power supply of each room and they can provide automation features for controlling the power. You can see the switches are closed, but the light is on. This controls that. So moving to another room. These units are deployed in different rooms, providing different functionalities. Like in the previous room, it provided the ability for controlling the power supply. This here only has a sensor as an accelerometer. They send real-time sensor data to the Raspberry Pi, which acts as a central IoT hub. So this is the Raspberry Pi, the central IoT hub, which is the brains of the system. This has a 240-volt relay, which controls the power supply of the whole building. This is further connected to through a sound system, and it also controls the water supply of the whole building, as you can see. So the Raspberry Pi collects data from all the sensors, and if it receives erroneous data from multiple units, it triggers a warning. Aksh, can you shake the accelerometer? Okay, so one unit is being shaken right now. So if there is earthquake is detected in another room, so that killed the water supply. And it also started the siren and shut down all the lights in both the rooms. You can see the real-time data being sent by the Node MCU units to the Raspberry Pi. This also plots the data sent by the Raspberry Pi to Azure is plotted on a map. So as you can see, an earthquake has been detected in Jodhpur. It also records all the sensor data, which can be used for further analysis.
Of our project, that is skin disease diagnosis. Using the custom vision service of Azure Cognitive Services, we have used it to train a model to predict different type of skin diseases
that may arise after disasters like tsunamis that are caused by earthquakes or floods in general. That is a major cause of illness due to poor hygienic conditions and lack of infrastructures in the aftermath of a disaster. Disease diagnosis is very crucial.
The accompanying Android app has the exported TensorFlow model from customvision.ai to predict diseases offline because network might not be available in disaster situations. It eliminates the need for medical test when there is lack of infrastructure during a calamity and provides faster medical diagnosis. The download link would be in a button below.
Okay, so I'll just show a demonstration of the app. For a skin disease, I searched on Bing. So this is a atopic dermatitis. The app detects the disease and also I can see the cure.
So the app provides the basic cure and also describes the symptoms that the patient might feel. This provides crucial information to the doctor because there is a lack of infrastructure during calamities to detect the diseases. Talk briefly about the technologies that we have used. We have primarily used Microsoft Azure as a cloud hosting platform. It hosts the Ubuntu virtual machine, which handles all the requests for the IoT hubs. And a custom vision service that is a part of Azure Cognitive Services for the skin app that was developed. For the storage solution, we have used SQLite-based database and Raspberry Pi as a main IoT hub, Node MCU as slave board, IoT board units. And further, hardware extensions such as an electronic valve, 240-volt relay and a speaker. So the IoT hub and the Azure backend, along with the database on the cloud, just gives us the glimpse of how the IoT edge part of it comes. The IoT hubs are at the edge of the cloud, and the cloud acts as a main storage for the main data.